हेलो गाइस, आई एम मिताली सिंह एंड आई एम करंटली वर्किंग एज अ लीगल इंटर्न एट लेक्सिस एंड कंपनी एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट आर्टिकल 23 ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद द इंट्रोडक्शन और आई वुड से वी विल स्टार्ट विद द हिस्ट्री पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया वेयर इंडिया एक्चुअली आई वुड से एक्चुअली फेस द कंसेप्ट ऑफ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन. देयर वॉज डिस्क्रिमिनेशन इन इंडिया, जेंडर अनइक्वालिटी था. And there were many things. So human trafficking was there in India, bonded labor existed. So we'll start with the introduction, which says that India, being the biggest democracy in the world, was also once a place of slavery and exploitation for children and adults. Before the enactment of the Constitution of India, there were several cases of slavery, exploitation, widespread practice of forced labor in India. But with the passage of time and the adoption of Constitution of the adoption of the Constitution of India, Article 23 came into force, and Article 23 in the Indian Constitution practices reduced, and the adoption of the Article 23 in the Indian Constitution actually reduced these practices to zero. Not zero, these practices are still still we can see in remote areas, but as compared to the previous scenario, we say that there's a lot of difference between the previous situation and the current situation of discrimination or slavery in India. So there are still many places where women are discriminated against because of their gender and other problems. Like in some places, they were not allowed to enter during their period weeks, during their menstruation cycle, but no established reasons was given for this practice. Still, there are many cases of human trafficking in northeastern states where still the government is not able to establish the cause and is not able to take concrete steps in order to stop those activities. But nonetheless, the Constitution of India ensures freedom and nobility to each person. Now we will talk about Article 23 of the Indian Constitution. So as per Article 23 of the Indian Constitution, traffic in individuals and hobo and other comparable types of constrained work are denied, and any negation of this arrangement will be an offense culpable as per law. Second, nothing in this article will keep the state from forcing mandatory help for public purposes. And in overwhelming such assistance, the state will not make any separation on grounds just of religion, race, rank or class or any of them. Features of Article 23 are, it protects both citizens and non-citizens against state and private individuals in terms of exploitation. And second, Article 35 authorizes Parliament to make laws for punishing the acts which are prohibited under Article 23, and third, it makes the state responsible for identifying and removing any such kind of bad practices happening in India. So practices which are mainly prohibited by according to Article 23 are beggar. First of all, begging is prohibited under Article 23, and we will start with the term beggar, what it actually means. So the term beggar is of Indian origin. The beggar was a framework where the government, indeed the British government officials and zamindars, used to propel the people to convey their products when they moved from one spot to another spot. It implies compulsory work without installment. Beggar establishes two components. First, it is to propel an individual to neutralize his will, and second, he isn't paid any compensation for that work. Now, second practice which is being prohibited by Article 23 of the Indian Constitution is traffic in human beings. This term implies selling and buying of people. Trafficking ka basically matlab hota hai selling and buying of a people from one person to another, sometimes from one country to another, which is still being practiced in India, in many parts of India. The selling and the buying of a person takes place from one country to another as if they are their chattels. Although slavery is not expressly mentioned in any of the Article of Indian Constitution or under Article 23, but it is included within the meaning of traffic in human beings. In pursuance of Article 23, Parliament has passed the Suppression of Immoral Traffic in Human and Girls Act 1956 for punishing human trafficking. Now, the last thing which is prohibited under Article 23 of the Indian Constitution, or the last practice which is prohibited, is bonded labor or forced labor. Here, the labor does not work because of only physical and mental force, but also because of his economic conditions, like to pay off his debts. In this way, he is forced to work, and if on time he is not able to pay off his debts, then the work sometimes gets doubled without any payment, or it passes to the next generation. So from here, the term bonded labor or forced labor came into force, and Article 23 and Article 22 of Indian Constitution prohibited the practice of bonded labor or forced labor in India. So that's it for this video. I hope as I was able to cover everything which comes under Article 23 of the Indian Constitution. So thank you so much, and I will see you in my next video.